Welcome to Finca Casa Bermeja. We are in a family business. This is a sustainable and organic lemon farm.
Could you tell us how your startup Kilimo fits into organic sustainable lemon farming?
Kilimo is an irrigation management solution. We help farmers make better irrigation decisions using data and AI to improve the efficiency of water use at the farm. We use a combination of satellite data and weather data to model how much water a farm uses, and we provide irrigation advice on top of that.
You know, with the platform they give us, we managed to reduce the water use in up to 12%. This area, in particular, is very dry.
I see.
To manage and to reduce the water impact, but not impact the lemons, is a very big concern.
I see.
Right? Our partner with Kilimo help us reduce the water use, but not sacrificing the production.
Tell me a little bit about fossil freedom at Vattenfall and what that means for you and for the company.
Well, it is, in a way, you could say, our purpose. So everything we do, we want to help the entire society to be fossil-free. And that means that every single piece, regardless of whether it's transport or the way that you extract a material, the way that you produce that material, transport it to site, all of that should be fossil-free and be done in a responsible way.
So for the entire supply chain, the entire ecosystem is free of fossil fuels?
Yes, we do our share, but then in collaborations with actors in the supply chain, in collaboration with our customers, in collaboration with local communities, we help all these different actors to secure that we can have a fossil-free society.
You know, you've mentioned to me as well that focus on sustainability is not just an environmental thing, but it's also a human rights thing, and I'd love to hear you talk about that.
I think for everyone in Sweden, sustainability is really about striking the balance between the environmental, social, and economic aspect. If we want to change and tackle the climate, we need to safeguard the environmental aspects like resource efficiency, but also at the same time secure that it's done in a fair way. We need to build tons of new wind production. We need to have new grids connecting the industries that need to use fossil-free fuel sources instead of the fossil fuels. And when doing that, it's going to impact people. So we have a lot of interaction with local communities and so forth. So it's really everything fits together.
We have a very diversified matrix in terms of energy generation. So we got water in the south, we got solar in the north, you know, one of the driest deserts in the world.
Yeah.
We got some good wind also, because it's helping us push energy transition and accelerate.
What are some of the practical scenarios that you're seeing AI help?
It's coming fast. For example, prediction models for resources like wind
or
sun, it's in there. This right here, what's the frequency on we need to clean the panels?
Clean the panel, repair.
Like so that's a lot of machine learning. And we're doing a lot of data classification, a lot of applications that are helping us out in that sense.
So what do you do at Peace Parks?
So we involved in transfrontier conservation areas, and this is the management of large ecosystems that stretch across international boundaries, international borders.
By bringing in certain species, it allows for the introduction of other key species. By creating biodiversity, it brings additional animals in, which fill the spaces that are missing.
So in some of our major parks, where we've got quite significant rhino populations, we've had to deploy all kinds of measures to aid those parks in the protection of rhino.
And technology plays a pretty big role in those types of protections,
It
spans from us being able to identify threats using AI with image recognition, right through to us being able to track where they're going to be, what influences their movement, and what factors we should be looking at to counter the threat.
We've had quite a positive approach to rhino conservation.
Right.
In one of the parks that we work, which is the Nav National Park in Mozambique, we've been proactively reintroducing rhino in partnership with the Mozambique government, which is perhaps the first rhino in that part of the world for, yeah, more than 30 years.
Wow.
And it was a lot of work had to be done to make sure that we can protect and conserve these animals.
Right. Talk about an amazing usage of AI. The final product
is a baby rhino.
Yeah.